Dear learners, welcome to session on design and development of e-content. Today, we'll be discussing about the concept of instructional design and its various stages. Also, different instructional design models available today, and also we'll be talking about the different types of e-content. E-content is digital form of content and is the need of the hour in this increasingly digital world. It is gaining importance in teaching and learning, and if we want to design it, the foremost thing to do will be to prepare the content which can be delivered digitally, that is as digital content or e-content. Consciously and unconsciously, we all approach any new task by making a plan and design for successful execution of that task. It is also true for teaching and learning activities. Remember, whenever a conference or seminar or debate or any other activity is to be organized, if it is planned and designed well, it is likely to be implemented to successful completion. We see teachers and learners switching from expensive textbooks to digital course materials, as digital materials have greater capacity for interactivity, and thus teachers and learners and peers as well can use it. E-content can be designed and developed to be used, reused, and distributed without any quality loss on sharing. Well-developed e-content can be delivered umpteen times to different learners without any loss of quantity or any quality. Also, course components like units, lessons, and media elements such as graphics and animations can be reused in different contexts. In this module, we'll be learning about designing and development of e-content. Designing is an essential part of any activity. You must have felt during your school years that some classes were better planned and structured than others. The reason being that the effectiveness of any instructional program or any instructional material depends upon an appropriate planning or designing, what in professional parlance is known as instructional design. Instructional design is a relatively young discipline. Designing depends on need analysis, experience, and creative inputs. Therefore, the purpose of designing instruction is to create situations that enhance learning opportunities for an individual. This reflects that instruction to become effective has to be uniquely designed based on need and many other factors which are studied by the instructional designers. To put it simply, instructional design is the plan of action with a purpose. Let's talk about what is e-content. The design and development of e-content includes all kinds of content which can be created and delivered through both standalone or network electronic devices. The purpose of e-content development is to create an information-rich society. Well-designed, developed, and validated e-content will provide access to high-quality, meaningful digital content and serve as an effective virtual teacher. Before understanding the designing and development of e-content, it is essential to understand the meaning of instructional design. Instructional design is a process using which we design learning situations, and there are common tasks involved in most of the models available in practice. Instructional design is a systematic plan adopted for enhancing experiences in human learning. Let's talk about the meaning of instructional design. If you look in Wikipedia, instructional design is the practice of creating instructional experiences which make the acquisition of knowledge and skill more efficient, effective, as well as appealing. The process broadly consists of determining the current status of learner understanding, defining the end goal of the instructional material, and creating some interventions to assess the transition. This systematic approach provides a step by step process for the analysis of learner's need and the design and development of the material. Instructional design is a systematic process that is used to develop teaching learning resources. It increases the possibility of learning besides encouraging learners to learn faster and gain deeper levels of understanding. It is like an umbrella term where experts visualize it as a process, science, reality as well as discipline. Let us talk about a generic instructional design model. Most common and popular model used for creating instructional design is ADDIE model. We can see that this model permeates in all the ID models available. ADDIE is acronym of analysis, design, development, implementation, and evaluation. It is also known as instructional systems design or the ISD model. AIDDE model has 5 phases: analysis, design, develop, implement, and evaluate, under which many more steps are undertaken. This is one of the most dynamic ID model. Let us study the different phases in detail in the context of e-content design and development. The first phase, analysis, is meant for examining the suitability of the e-content which is to be developed. Under this, we analyze the learning needs, context, learner, task, and content with reference to the e-content we plan to develop. Analyzing the learning needs is basically identifying the needs from the perspective of different learners, teachers, subject experts, practitioners, policymakers. The need should be clearly stated. It's very important that the need is clearly stated. Second in analysis is the contextual analysis, which is collecting data related to context of learning, such as the learning environment. For example, whether the e-content which is to be developed is for the individual or group, whether it's for formal or informal learning, whether it is to be facilitated by a teacher or it is for self-learning. The third is learner analysis, which is basically preparing your learner's profile. For this, we collect data related to the learner's academic levels and attributes such as skills, motivation, visual literacy, language competency, learning styles. It helps us to know about the learner. Another step is, under the analysis is task analysis, which is focusing on the purpose of developing the e-content. It helps us in deciding whether this is developed for educating, training, creating awareness, developing skills, or so on. Next is the content analysis, which is preparing a good content outline. Good content comprehension is required before designing and developing any content. It includes verifying the content with respect to cognitive appropriateness, factual accuracy, and completeness. It also includes classifying the content into facts, concepts, principles, processes, and procedures. The second phase of ADDIE model is the design phase. It is concerned with defining the learning objectives, structuring the content logically, specifying the instructional and evaluation strategies, and preparing for visual and technical design. Learning objectives under the design phase are the statements that describe what the learner will be able to do at the end of the course or the program and should be defined in clear, realistic, and measurable terms. It also involves preparing a detailed content outline in which content is thoroughly analyzed and logically organized. Content is to be structured logically, following simple to complex, known to unknown, concrete to abstract, and general to specific principles. Also in design phase, instructional strategies are to be clearly stated. Depending on the learning style of the learners and the nature of the content, we have to decide the appropriate instructional strategy. We should also decide the appropriate media mix, which is a combination of audio, video, graphics, animations, simulations. Also in the design phase, learner evaluation strategies such as practice, computer marked or tutor marked assessments, pre-test, post-test, remedial tests, they have to be specified right at this stage. We have to decide about the formative and summative assessments. Before developing the content for the selected course, review the proposed learning objectives. Make sure that the content, assessments, tests, exercises match the objectives stated. In the design phase, all the activities for the development phase are to be decided, like content analysis and its sequencing, formulation of objectives, teaching and learning, evaluation strategies, they have to be specified here. In case of a multimedia program, the interactivity part is also be decided at this stage. Some of the important points that should be kept in mind are like content and strategies chosen need to be contextually relevant. It should be gender and racially sensitive. It should promote concerns related to environmental awareness. It should be peace oriented. It should focus on inclusion. It should recognize the constitutional values and scientific temper. Prototype testing is included in the design phase for enabling the necessary changes before development. The next stage is the development phase, which is related to the creation of a storyboard. Storyboard is nothing but scripting the entire course content. In e-content development, the storyboard describes step-by-step script of the final outcome of the e-content. It is like a blueprint of the course with each and every detail along with the content notes. The storyboard is created based on the objectives and the instruction strategies. A storyboard is organized sequentially, screen by screen, and each screen is stretched out with design notes and specifications. Here, the developers create and assemble the content assets and learning objects. Programming and integration of all media elements into a cohesive multimedia package are part of this phase. In the implementation phase, materials are to be distributed to learners. A comprehensive implementation strategies document is to be developed, which should cover the course curricula, the learning outcomes, the method of delivery in terms of hardware and software requirements and testing procedures. It should be tested on all platforms like websites, learning management systems. In fact, the implementation phase should be interwoven with evaluation. As learners receive the instruction, it is imperative that we get answers to the questions like their liking, whether the material is being used, whether the learning is happening or not, and whether the materials are making any difference in their levels of learning. The instructional designer will have to revise the approach, and this is a continuous cycle till the objectives are achieved. The last stage, the fifth phase is the evaluation phase. It helps in checking whether the e-content developed is as per the requirement and is qualitatively okay. It is done in two parts, formative and summative evaluation. Formative evaluation is a continuous evaluation done in each stage of the ADDI process or the ID model. The summative evaluation is done at the end of the whole process and is aimed at determining the adequacy of the e-content material in achieving the objectives. The e-content should be revised at all the stages based on the feedback received. There are other ID models which are also used for designing and developing the e-content. Let's discuss a few of them. Dick and Carey approach model. It is another well-known instructional design model which was proposed by Walter Dick and Lau Carey in 1978. It was a step forward to not viewing instructional components in isolation, but the model addresses the instruction as an entire system, focusing on the interrelationship between context, content, learning and instruction. They said that all components like instructor, learners, materials, instructional activities, delivery system and learning and performance environments interact with each other and work together holistically to bring about the desired student learning outcomes. The components of the system approach model, also known as Dick and Carey model, are: first, identify instructional goals, conduct instructional analysis, analyze the learners and the context, on that basis write performance objectives, develop assessment instruments, then after finalizing that, develop the instruction strategy, which is also very important. After that, develop and select instructional material, design and conduct formative evaluation of instruction, revise instruction, then design and conduct summative evaluation. As you can see from the figure, one can identify the instructional goals and after that conduct the instruction analysis. The other will be identify the entry behavior. Input from both these sources which will help us in writing the performance objectives. Then after performance objectives, we develop criterion reference test, we develop instructional strategies, we develop and select instructional material, we develop and conduct formative evaluation, after that we revise instruction, we conduct summative evaluation and then come back and try to revise the whole process. Yet another ID model used for making multimedia e-content is rapid prototyping. Here, rapid means happening in a short amount of time, happening quickly, moving quickly, and prototyping refers to testing ideas like a mock-up. It involves building a quick working model so that various design features, ideas, concepts, functionalities, output and performance can be tested early in the process. You don't have to wait till the end of the process. The idea behind is early detection of gaps and its rectification. In this, the design, developmental and evaluation phases are combined. It is a non-linear approach that produces a sample working model that is a scaled-down representative version of the whole e-content or the course. In the design process, early development of a small-scale prototype that can be used to test out certain key features of the design is very useful. The rapid prototype design phases are: you assess the needs and analyze the content, you set objectives, you construct prototypes, you utilize prototypes, you install and maintain the system. Rapid prototyping also requires the use of tools which enable modularity and plasticity. Modularity is having the ability to easily modify, remove, or add things to your instructional model. While plasticity is the ability to quickly make changes to your model in a cost-effective manner. Whether we are looking at traditional classroom or online learning or anything in between, there appears to be a need to quickly produce a prototype, see its efficacy, and proceed to build more if it is fine. It is much cost and time effective, and rather than developing a full-blown course and then finding the gaps. In the present-day scenario, instructional designers and trainers find themselves having to do more fast at a faster rate and in a way that they grab the attention of the learners who are constantly on social media even while interacting within the class. After discussing the instructional design models of developing e-content, let's also try to know about the types of e-content. E-content is digital content and uses one media or multiple types of media like audio, video, graphics, animations, and text in combination for teaching and learning purpose. It can be of many types. Text-based, it can be the first one, the text-based. A text file which may be available as a PDF or EPUB which uses text as a medium of communication with the learner. It is the basic type of e-content. The second is image-based. E-content which uses image to communicate the content. This image can be manually created and digitized or digitally created. Infographics, concept maps are examples of digitally created graphics which help in concept clarification as well as concept attainment in teaching and learning. The third is audio-based, which includes speech, music, sound, which are used to convey the content. Podcasts are being increasingly used to reach the learners. Reach and the appeal of music is immense, and so is the power of audio. It can be tapped to develop e-content as well. Another type of e-content is animation and the stimulation, which are also quite widely used for creating e-content. Video has emerged as a powerful type of e-content. In fact, MOOCs or the online courses are using it predominantly. Another type of e-content we see is interactive multimedia, or in short IIM. It uses multimedia integrated with interactivity. Multimedia is an interwoven combination of minimum two elements out of text, pictures, animations, video and sound. Interactive multimedia is integrated and woven form of interactivity in multimedia so that learners are able to interact actively with the content. Another way of classifying e-content is on the basis of increased access to knowledge. It could be encyclopedia. Online encyclopedias are like Wikipedia are very good e-content resources to make knowledge reach all. Open educational resources, or the OERs, are the free educational resources available to all. It is one of the growing fields of educational resources, well appreciated by all learners as well as teachers. The reusable learning objects allow digital material to be used in various combinations as per the context and the need. Under LO, asset is the smallest indivisible digital unit for the information transfer. For example, a picture or a short text, a plain picture text combination, or a simple small animation. As learning objects can be combined in different ways, they're also known as reusable learning objects. Another type of e-content could be online dictionaries. According to Wikipedia, online dictionaries are very good resources for teaching and learning. There are many dictionaries available online which are very good resource. There are multilingual dictionaries also available online which can be accessed by anyone who is interested to learn. E-books are also another type of e-content. E-books are digitized version of books and are becoming increasingly popular because of the ease of access and availability. According to Wikipedia, e-book is a book published, made available in digital form, consisting of text, images, or can have both, readable on a flat panel display of computers or any other electronic devices. Although sometimes defined as an electronic version of a printed book, some e-books exist without a printed equivalent. They are only available as e-books. UGC in its 10th plan document has talked about certain characteristics of e-content. They should be technologically friendly so that it can be easily downloaded and used on any computer. It should be learner-centric and friendly so that it is useful in self-instructional mode for easy navigation. It should be teacher friendly so as to be used in various teaching learning methods such as classrooms, lectures, tutoring in a group, lab situations and many other. It should have learner-centric pedagogy. Specifically, the designer of the e-content should pay attention to teaching model used, such as simple information communication, exploratory approach, discovery approach, mastery learning. Many types of interactivities should be included to make learning effective and efficient. The e-content should also focus on having inbuilt self-evaluation. The e-content should use plenty of evaluation material to give feedback to the learners as to his or her achievement in the topic of the course. It should include formative as well as summative evaluation. Another characteristic of e-content should be support object-based learning and teaching. The content should specifically state the objects of the learning and teaching and should employ different strategies for skill, competency and functionality developments. So today we have discussed that the purpose of e-content development is to create an information-rich society. Well-developed e-content can be delivered umpteen times to different learners without any loss of quantity or quality. Instructional design is a systematic process using which we design learning situations, and there are common tasks involved in most of the models available today. ADDIE is a generic IT model. Some other models are Dick and Carry model, rapid prototyping. There are various type of e-contents which can be used according to our requirement and context. Happy designing and development of e-content. Thank you.